packing is the arrangement of particles. Square close packing is arrangement of particles in such a way that there is a square arrangement will come in the continuous arrangement of particles, and there will be a six-membered hexagon ring in hexagonal plane. So, because I don't have enough space here, I'm rubbing this one-dimension part. So that we will discuss square close packing over here. So, what is meant by square close packing? It should be two-dimensional. So, particles are tightly packed. This is the first layer. This is the first layer of particles, where the second layer of particles will be lying exactly down to the first layer. The second layer of particles will be lying exactly down to the first layer, like this. And have you observed or not? And in this continuous close packing also, there is certain space is left over. This is the space left over. Okay, which is looking like a rhombus shape. If you separate this space left over in the continuous close packing and kept it aside, it will be looking like this. This is the space left over in the continuous close packing, right? And focus on any one of the particle. Focus on any one of the particle, right? I will focus on this particle, closely observe. I will be focusing on this particle and count down. How many atoms is in it is in touch with? It is in touch with total 1, 2, 3, 4. So in square close packing, each and every particle is in touch with 4 different particles. Okay. So and this is said to be coordination number. This is said to be coordination number. What is meant by coordination number is the number of particles in touch with one particular atom. In the continuous close packing, the number of particles in touch with one particular atom is said to be square close packing. Coming to this atom, this particular atom is in touch with 4 different atoms. That is why its coordination number is 4. Right? Someone is HA. Right? So here the coordination number of square close packing is 4. And the dimensions required or parameters required to define certain kind of two-dimensional square close packing unit cell is along x-axis and along y-axis. So we have length and height. We have length and height, and as well as angle between this length and height. Right? Imagine that the length is A and the height is B and the angle is alpha. So the total number of parameters required to define the two-dimensional square close packing is 3. What are those? Length A, height B, and angle between length and height alpha. So total 3 parameters we require, right? So this is about square close packing with coordination number 4. How do these arrangement comes? That is also important. The second layer will be lying exactly on the first layer. Then we will have certain kind of square close packing structure. Okay, is this clear to everyone? Right then. Then we will see hexagonal close packing in the two-dimensional. Coming to the hexagonal close packing in a two-dimensional. What is meant by hexagonal close packing is the second layer, this is the first layer, the second layer will be kept exactly in between the space left over of the first layer. See, this is the space. This is a inverted V shape. Here you can see an inverted V shape. So the second layer will be exactly trapped into that space left over. See this one. Like this. The second layer will be exactly present at the spaces left over. Have you observed or not? In the previous case of square close packing, in the spaces left over, I got an rhombus-like shape, which is like a diamond. And here, you will get a shape like a triangle. Here you will get a shape like triangle. This is the case in case of square closed packing. The solid state mostly involves the stretches and mensuration mathematics also. That is why I'm telling all this fact. This is in case of space left over in square closed packing, and this is the space left over in case of hexagonal closed packing, right? Now, coming to the hexagonal closed packing, I will consider any one of the atom. This is the one particular atom that I am going to focus. This is the one particular atom that I am going to focus. Now the thing is, what is the coordination of number of hexagonal closed packing? What is the coordination number of hexagonal closed packing? Coming to the hexagonal closed packing, what is meant by coordination number? First of all, the number of atoms in touch with one particular atom. The number of atoms in touch with one particular atom in the closed packing is said to be coordination number, right? So I am going to focus on this particular atom, and it is in touch with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the coordination number of square closed packing is 4, where the coordination number of hexagonal closed packing is 6. So here the coordination number is 6. And the number of parameters required is the same as that of the number of parameters required is the same as that of square closed packing, which is height and length and angle between length and height. So A is the length, B is the height, alpha is the angle between them. So this is about two-dimensional hexagonal closed packing. Now the thing is, the question coming in my mind is, among this two-dimensional square closed packing and hexagonal closed packing, which one is more effectively packed? Which one is more effectively packed? What is meant by effectively packing is leaving minimum space. As I told you, there are some spaces left over even in the continuous closed packing of solid. And you have seen the spaces left over near graphical representation that I have drawn just right now here. So when you see these spaces left over on the continuous closed packing in a diagrammatic representation, what you feel that among this square and square closed packing and hexagonal closed packing, which one is more effectively packed? Any one of you? Yes. Any one of you, please do respond.
Hexagonal.
Hexagonal, yes.
Hexagonal.
Why? Yes, yes, hexagonal. Why? Because it is having more effectively packed, more closely packed. See, the area of rhombus, as I shown you in the square closed packing, the space left over is limited to similar to rhombus. And in case of this hexagonal closed packing, the space left over here is similar to triangle. So the area of, in a limited space, the area of rhombus is greater than that of area of a triangle. In a limited space, I'm talking. Okay? Right. On that basis, we can answer this more, which one is more effectively packed. So hexagonal closed packing is more effectively packed by leaving minimum space. Okay? Right then. Next is coming to three-dimensional, where three-dimensional is again two types. Three-dimensional is important. Why I have explained this 1D and 2D is where you will get clarity. This three-dimensional is more important, and this is what a real solid exists. 1D, 2D doesn't exist. A solid, whatever the matter you take, what is a matter? It has some mass and occupies volume. And volume is about space occupied by it in the three-dimensional axis. So 1D and 2D are purely hypothetical, the 3D is the real. So the three-dimensional closed packing is, the three-dimensional closed packing is simple closed packing. Simple closed packing and CCP, cubical closed packing, or FCC. Remember one thing, CCP and FCC are same only. Now I'm telling you what is meant by CCP is cubical closed packing, right? And FCC, face-centered closed packing. I will tell you that one also. And hexagonal closed packing. All these are quite similar, except hexagonal. Hexagonal will be a bit different, right? Coming to simple closed packing, see this one. This is the way of particles arranged. It is similar to the square closed packing in 2D. It is similar to the square closed packing in 2D. What is square closed packing? The second layer will be lying exactly on the first layer. This is the way particles are arranged. But actually, this kind of arrangement is 2D. But what we need is a 3D molecule. So the third layer will be exactly lying on the first layer, which I am not able to represent over here because the board is 2D. The third layer is also exactly lying on the first layer. Okay, so how many parameters we require? This is the third layer I am writing. I am not repeating the same pattern, right? So how many, like this, or else I will represent like this. This is the third layer, which is exactly present on the first two layers. Right? It will be quite confusing for you while observing on board, but that's it. Right? So here it is three-dimensional. So we require length, height, and breadth. An angle between length and height, alpha, beta, and gamma. So the number of parameters required, to define a three-dimensional unit cell is total 6 parameters. Length, height, breadth are the 3 measurements, and angle between them, alpha, beta, gamma, are the rest of the 3. So total 6 parameters are required. So this is about simple closed packing. And in this simple closed packing only, we will have primitive cubic unit cell, face-centered cubic unit cell, and body-centered cubic unit cell, right? So this is about very important introduction to solid state. If anyone have doubts in this, as you all know, primitive BCC and FCC, we'll discuss along with that, or we'll enter into the questionnaire, previous year questionnaire, what we do. If anyone have doubts in knowing BCC and FCC, we'll go on with that, or else we can enter into the direct questionnaire. Okay, I will do one thing. I will explain all these important basics for the calculation part in one unit cell. Okay? So, a unit cell is quite similar to a cube. If I have drawn a square, it represents 2D closed packing. Okay? So, a 3D closed packing is quite similar to a cube. Imagine that all sides are equal in this cube. All sides are equal in this cube, which is A. Length of each side is A. Okay? Now, particles in this unit cell, this is a unit cell. What is a unit cell? Repeated unit in the space lattice. Okay? So, in this unit cell, particles can be arranged at a different positions. And what are those different positions is, particles can occupy at corner. So the completely blank particle is present at corner. These are the corner particles. And in a cube, total 8 corners will be there. In a cube, total 8 corners will be there. And these are the total 8 corners. Right? And remember one thing, unit cell is not an isolated piece. Unit cell is the repeated unit. Just like a polymer. What is a polymer? It is the unit of many single units. Ethylene molecules continuously added together to form a polyethylene. And in the same way, a unit cell is a repeated unit. So imagine that in this room, I have a corner. And that corner is shared in between 8 different same identical rooms. Right? For example, this is a book. And here I have 8 corners. Here the height is very less. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then 7, 8. Now, if I consider this particular corner particles, this corner particles is equally shared in between 8 different unit cells. Okay? one particular particle present at corner is equally shared in between eight different unit cells because it is the common point of eight different unit cells, right? So what is the composition of this particle in one unit cell? If it is the common particle in eight different unit cells, what is its composition with respect to one unit cell? In one unit cell, its composition is, in one unit cell, its composition is 1/8. In one unit cell, its composition is 1/8, right? The other site where particles can be arranged in a unit cell is face, right? This is one particular face. In a cube, total 6 different faces will be there. You just look over the room that you are sitting right now, and you can count that left side, right side, front, back, up and above, up and below. So like that, total 6 different faces will be there. This is the first face I am drawing, and the center face is this. I am drawing only horizontal lines to make sure what the difference between corner and face center particle. And this is the second face. Right, and this is the left side wall of your room, and this is the center of that face, and this is the particle, right? And this is the back side. This is the back side of your room, and the center of this room is present over here, and this is the particle present, right? And this is the upside. This is the upside face of the room, and this is the particle present at the center. Like the total, how many we got? 5. And this is the face that present in front of you, in front of you. And this is the center, and this is the particle present. A particle present at the wall. So the wall present right side to you is the common wall between this room and the next room. So the particle present at the face center, that means present at the center of the wall, is 50% present in this room, and the other 50% is present in the next room. So the face centered particle is half of this unit cell and half present in the next unit cell. So with respect to one unit cell, what is its composition? In one unit cell, its composition is half. Only 50% is present in this unit cell. Next 50% is present in the next unit cell, right? So this is about face center particle. And the next is coming to the body center. So body center means which is present exactly center of the unit cell. So this is the actual center, but here I'm not finding a little bit arrangement I made. I was completely shaded that body center. Completely shading that body center. Right? So there will be only one center of body, and 100% it is present in one unit cell. So number of body centered particles present in one unit cell is one only. Because particle present at the exactly center of the room is not shared in between the units. Okay. Yes? Anyone have doubts? Right. And the next is edge center. Right? And edge center particles will be different, where there will be total 8 edges present. 4 edges from this wall, which is front to you, 4 edges from the back side of your wall, total 4 plus 4, 8, and 2 from the left of you, 2 from the right of you, total like that 12 edges will be there. So these are the edge particles. So this is the different types of arrangements possible. These are the different types of arrangements possible in a unit cell. What are the 4 different types of arrangement? Corner. Like that, how many corners will be possible? 8 corners. And what is the composition of corner particle in one unit cell? 1/8. and the next pattern is face center, and it is in one unit cell, it is half only present, and body center, it is present 100%. Coming to edge center, an edge center is the common point of four different unit cell. Imagine that here is the, it is the edge center. This is the board, this is the edge center, and this is the common point of four rooms, below two and above two. So in one unit cell, its composition is 1/4. In one unit cell, its composition is 1/4. So this is the different locations of particles that could be possible in a 3D unit cell. Okay, right. Now the formula for number of effective atoms. This is the most repeated question. In most of the competitive examinations like mains, advanced, and BITSET. Okay, the formula for number of effective atoms is, the whole formula I am writing here. Total number of effective, what is mean by effective atoms is 100% it is present. Total number of effective atoms in one unit cell is equal to number of corner particles by 8, because each corner particle composition is 1/8, plus number of face centered particle by 2, because each face centered particle is 50% only present in this particle, and number of body centered particle by 1, because a body centered particle is 100% present in the same unit cell, plus number of edge centered particles by 4, because a particle present at edge center is 1/4 of its composition. So this is the formula that we use to count the number of effective atoms. Okay, and one more important formula is density. Density of unit cell is also an important concept. The general formula for density of any given substance is mass by volume. The general formula for density of a given unit cell is mass by volume. So mass of each particle present in the unit cell into number of effective atoms. Here m is mass of each particle, but we should count mass of all the particles present in the atom. That is why we should consider number of atoms present in that unit cell by, so this is the mass by volume. Volume of the cube is a cube. Volume of the particle is a cube. Okay, and into n naught. For one unit cell you are counting, so Avogadro number. Here n naught indicates Avogadro number. So here a indicates edge length. One should know the edge length relation, then only he can solve the numerical. Very, very important is one should be familiar with the relation of edge length, and the radius of atom for the particular arrangement. For example, for PCC, that means primitive unit cell, the relation is A is equal to 2R. Like that, everyone should know. Okay. Anyways, all these concepts will be covered in the numericals that we are going to cover. Okay, right. Now we'll see question 8. Right. This is the question, previous year questions. And the question is, in a face center, cubic lattice. If you have any doubts at any time of the class, you can express your doubt. In a face-centered cubic lattice, atom A occupies the corner positions. Atom A occupies the corner positions Atom A occupies the corner positions and atom B and atom B occupies the face centered position. Atom B occupies the face centered, the face centered position. Right? If one atom of B is missing from one of the face center, the formula of the compound. So this kind of question is more frequent in the national level competitive examination and even in bit set also. The formula of the compound. Okay, he will be giving different types of particles saying X, Y, Z, A, B, C, and he will give you the position of that particular particle in the cube and wanted you to find out the molecular formula of that from the given data. Okay, now read the question carefully. There is a solid AB, and the particles A occupies at corner, and atom B occupies at face center. The twist is one of the atom B is missing. Then what will be the molecular formula? So if A is present at corner, total 8 A's will be there, 8 by 8. Each particle composition is 1. Like that, total 8 A particles are there. Then the number of particles, what is the formula for number of particles? See the formula that I gave you just right now. The formula for number of effective atoms in one unit cell is equal to number of corner particles by 8 and number of face center particles by 2. I'm going to use the same formula, which will simplify all these certain kind of questions at one point. Okay, so now I'm going to use that formula. Remember the given data, particles of A is present at corner and B is present at face center and one of the B is missing. Now, by using the given data, we will be solving this question. A is present at corner. Total eight particles are present. Number of A atoms is equal to number of corner atoms by eight. So number of corner atoms is 8 and each particle is composition is 1 by 8, so it will be equal to 1. Okay, and coming to B, it is present at face center, and like that total 6 particles are present. Other than you simply write atoms, because he has given atoms, he also write atoms. And then number of B atoms, actually total 6 face center. You clearly write that total 8 corners, and here total 6 face centers are present. Actually you are writing how many are present actually, right? Number of B atoms is, he said that number of B atoms is 5 only. There is 6 positions for face center, but the reality is one of the B is missing. So if one of the B is missing, the number of B atoms will be 5 by 6. Okay, right? And according to law of fixed ratio or definite proportions, the ratio of two different elements in a compound is always fixed. So here in the stoichiometry, in the first year stoichiometry, we see this concept, which is law of chemical combinations. And one of the important law is law of definite proportions. According to law of definite proportions, the ratio to each element in a given compound is always fixed. So now I will take the ratio between A and B, where number of A atoms is 1 and number of B atoms is 5/6. And the ratio will be 6:5. That means the molecular formula is A6B5. So the molecular formula of that given compound is A6B5. This is for 6 particles. If it is with respect to composition, one moment. If it is with respect to the composition, the face-centered particle's composition, with respect to composition we are doing, each face particle is present half only in this unit cell. Okay? So with respect to composition, if we do, each particle is present 1/2, 5 particles will be present 5/2. 5 particles will be present 5/2. Then now you take the ratio with respect to composition we are doing, number of A particles and number of B particles. And number of A particles is 1 and number of B particles is 5/2, then it will be 2:5. Then the respective formula will be A2B5. So A2B5 is the molecular formula with respect to composition. A6B5 is the ratio with respect to number of particles. Okay? Right. Next, we'll see one numerical based on edge length and radius relation. As I told you, we have different types of unit cells like primitive unit cell, face-centered and body-centered. One should know this relation, then only he will be able to answer certain questions. These are very easy questions. The very easy questions in solid state will be coming on the relation between edge length, A, and radius of each atom, that is R. For primitive unit cell, that is PCC, it will be A is equal to 2R. Or you can also write R is equal to A/2. This is the relation between edge length A and the radius R for PCC. Coming to BCC, right? BCC will be a different one, where in case of BCC, the number of particles present along cube corner are only in touch, or you can say body center diagonal. So since the particles present alongside are not in touch with each other, we don't consider this relation. How come this A is equal to 2R for a primitive cubic unit cell is, in a primitive cubic unit cell, the particles present along the edge are in touch with each other. That is why directly we can write that A is equal to 2R. Right? When it comes to BCC, particles present along the body diagonal. That means you need to connect the diagonal of a corner of a front face, upward front face corner, with the backside downward corner. That is said to be body diagonal. And the formula for body diagonal is √3A. So it will be √3A is equal to 4R. This is the relation. This is the relation for edge length A and radius, which can also be written as A is equal to 4R by root 3. This is the relation for BCC. And at last, FCC. FCC or CCP is same. Remember, face-centered cubic lattice or cubical close packing are similar. Okay? And in this case, particles present along the face diagonal are in touch. There is a difference. Particles present along the body diagonal are in touch in case of BCC. That is why it is body diagonal. For a cube, the formula for body diagonal is root 3. That is why we have taken root 3 is equal to 4R, because along body diagonal, two atoms means 4R. But coming to the face centered, particles along the face diagonal are only in touch, and the formula for face diagonal of a cube is root 2A. The formula for face diagonal of a cube is root 2A is equal to 4R. If three particles are present along a face diagonal, then you will be getting the total length as 4R. Okay, and the relation, we can also write it as A is equal to 2√2R. A is equal to 2√2R. Right? Someone of you can interact with me. It is like a quiet class going smoothly. I just want any one of you to respond on this relation between any one of you. Vaishnavi, respond.
Yes, sir.
Okay, and do you got this relation?
Sir, actually, screen is.
Yes. Yes, Vaishnavi. Is there any problem with the screen?
Yes, sir, it's not clear.
You would have informed that earlier, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, anyways, what is the problem?
I'm having poor connection, sir.
Okay, you are having a poor internet connection.
Yes, so that's why I can't respond.
Okay, it's okay. Yeah. Anyone else? See, this is not a serious science lab. Yes, please.
Sir, can you explain this PCC once again?
PCC, the relation?
Yeah, in the form of a diagram.
Okay. Now listen carefully, everyone. In PCC, particles will be present along the corner only. There is no other positions that will be occupied by a particle in a cube when it comes to PCC. This is PCC. Okay, and we all know there will be 8 different corners, and particles observe this one corner only, this one edge length. This is one corner, this is the second corner. Now observe this very closely. This is the one particle present at this corner, and this is the other particle present at the corner. Okay, so actually the diagram is what I've drawn is different. See, this is the radius of the first particle, and this is the radius of the second particle. And in mathematically, what we indicate the edge length, it is said to be A. And from this diagram, we can say that the edge length A is equal to the half distance of this total is nothing but 2R. Which is A is equal to 2R, that is why we got R is equal to A by 2. Now, is that clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, when it comes to BCC, particles present at the corner are not in touch. That is why we didn't took the same relation. Why? Because the particle present at the body center will come in between these two particles which are present at the corner. That is why we have taken the particles, where do they are in touch? They are particles in touch with body diagonal, the particle present upward of the front face, and the body diagonal, which is present exactly center of the cube and the bottom corner. So that is why we got this different relations. Okay. Why these relations are very important is if you have this if you know this relation, you can answer questions directly. That is the thing. Okay. Right. Now we will see a question based on this concept, and you will come to know how many times certain kind of model questions are repeated, right? Question is copper. Copper crystallizes, so it is a crystal. So we all the solids that we are discussing in this topic is only crystalline. As you know, crystalline and amorphous, and we will be covering only crystalline. Copper crystallizes. Copper crystallizes in FCC with a unit cell. With a unit cell edge of 361 picometer. The radius of copper atom is. So he wanted you to calculate R. For that, he gave edge length. Isn't it a direct question? Yes, it is. So he gave the edge length, which is A, which is 361 picometer, and he wanted you to calculate R, which is radius. And what is the data he has given? It is said to be FCC. And what is the relation between A and R, edge length and radius, in case of FCC, which is A is equal to 2 root 2 R. A is equal to 2 root 2 R. From this, radius is equal to A by 2 root 2, which is 361 by 2 root 2. Okay, and on simplifying this, we'll be getting 128. It is not exact, 127.6 it is coming, which is approximately 128 picometer. So with this certain kind of relation, we can easily solve the numericals. Okay. And next one also I will discuss on the same area. But I will on the same area, which is okay. The next one is lithium. Lithium forms BCC. The length of the side of its unit cell is 351 picometer. And atomic radius of lithium is. Do you know the importance of solid state? The importance of solid state is the atomic mass of fluorine is 35.5. The atomic mass of copper is 63 point something. So how do they come to know that this exact fractional value is with the help of solid state? How do they come to know the exact atomic mass of a given substance is with the help of solid state, and as well as atomic radius also? We know that in a period from left to right, atomic radius decreases, and top to bottom atomic radius increases, but we don't know the exact value. The exact value of atomic radius and the comparable values can be easily calculated by using this solid state data. Okay, so he is saying that this time it is lithium metal, and this time it is BCC. Last time it is copper and FCC. What is the, he has given the edge length, which is 351 picometer. Remember about the units also, you should record the same in the same units, and he wanted you to calculate radius. So in case of BCC, what is the relation between edge length and radius? Any one of you. In case of BCC, what is the relation between edge length and radius?
हो गए
√3a is equal to 4r.
Yes, because it is through body diagonal, so it is √3a is equal to 4r. And from this we can write the formula for radius, that is √3/4 into a, which is nothing but √3/4 into 351, right? Which is coming 152 picometer. So the radius of lithium will be 152 picometer. Okay. So this is the numericals that repeated in the previous sessions by the relation of edge length and radius. Now we will see few numericals based on the formula of density. Few numericals based on the formula of density. Okay. Yeah. So, what is the number of effective atoms in BCC? What is someone muted me? Is there any problem with my class? That class is the main problem. All right, then coming to the question, before getting into the question, definitely we need some basics related to it. So tell me, any one of you tell me, what is the number of effective atoms in BCC and the number of effective atoms in FCC? I didn't explain this once, but you can solve it. I didn't told you the number of effective atoms in BCC or in FCC, but is there anyone? The number of effective atoms in BCC and the number of effective atoms in FCC. Okay, right. See this. At least now you can learn the number of atoms. The number of atoms in BCC. When it comes to BCC, only body-centered particle and corner particles will be present. So, corner by 8 plus body-centered by 1. This is the formula. I gave you the formula for number of atoms in any given unit cell. But with respect to BCC, there will be only corner and body center. That is why I have taken this one. And total 8 corners will be there, 8/8, 1/1. So it will be total 2. So the number of effective atoms present in BCC is 2. That is nothing but Z. The Z value for BCC, what is Z is number of atoms in one unit cell is 2. And coming to FCC.
4.
Coming to FCC. Yes. Number of atoms in FCC is 4. Yes, thank you. And in FCC, only corner particles and face-centered particles will be present. And the corner particles will be by 8 and the face center will be by 2. As I told you, there will be 8 corners, so 8/8. And the face center will be total 6, so 6/2, which is 1+3, which is 4. So the Z value, which is effective atoms for FCC, is 4. And PCC is 1, because in PCC only corner, there is no body center, there is no face center, there is no edge center, so only corner, so it will be 8/8, only 1. So the Z value for PCC is 1. I am not writing it here. Now, this is about number of atoms present in BCC and FCC. Why I have given these two is, these are more frequently coming in all kind of numericals. Okay, now coming to the question. Coming to the question, that number of unit cells. What is that question? number of unit cell. Listen carefully, it is just a reasoning type question. Number of unit cell. Okay, before getting answer this question, the formula of number of atoms you see. Number of atoms will be weighed by atomic mass. Weighed by atomic mass into Avogadro number. Weighed by atomic mass into Avogadro. How many number of atoms present in a given sample? This is the first stoichiometry. And number of molecules will be weighed by molecular mass into Avogadro number. This is the basic formula. Okay, where atomic mass in this topic is indicated with M. You all know that. So this is the formula for number of atoms in one unit cell. Number of atoms in any given sample. So when it comes to BCC, for BCC in one unit cell, two atoms are present. In one unit cell, two atoms are present. And for FCC, in one unit cell, four atoms are present. So for n atoms, the number of unit cells will be n into Avogadro number, which is number of moles. So this is the basic formula for number of unit cells. For each unit cell, there will be two atoms for BCC. For n atoms, it will be n into Avogadro number. Based on this concept only, we are going to solve the next question. This is an important formula, which is number of atoms is weighed by atomic mass into Avogadro number. Okay, now coming to the question, how many unit cells are present? Question is, how many unit cells? How many unit cells are present? Unit cells are present in a cube shaped. In a cube shaped. In a cube shaped ideal crystal. In a cube shaped ideal crystal. Ideal crystal of mass 1 gram. So this is the question. Any one of you please try to solve it. If not possible, I will explain. First you try to solve this question. That's why first I explained the concept, then I gave you the question to solve. How many unit cells are present in a cube shaped ideal crystal of, sorry, I didn't give the element. Very sorry. In a cube shaped ideal crystal of, NaCl. It is NaCl. Sorry. Crystal of NaCl of mass 1 gram. But he didn't mention the arrangement. He didn't mention the arrangement of unit cell, whether it is PCC, BCC or FCC. He will not mention because the sodium chloride is one of the repeated example about crystalline structure. You should know the crystalline arrangement of any NaCl. Any one of you, tell me what is the arrangement of NaCl, whether it is BCC, FCC or PCC. Any one of you. What is the regular arrangement? Sorry?
FCC.
PCC.
It is FCC. And one more repeated example that comes in examination is cesium chloride. Remember that cesium chloride is BCC. These are the most repeated examples. They don't mention, whenever there is a question based on NaCl or cesium chloride, they don't mention the arrangement or cubic unit cell type. The NaCl unit cell type is, it is FCC. Cesium chloride is BCC. Okay? Please note down this.
Sir, is it 2.57 into 10 power of 21?
Yes, it is. Yes, correct. Okay. So, to solve this question, what I will do is, I will calculate mass of one unit cell. In one unit cell, the number of particles in one unit cell, the number of particles is 4, because it is FCC. Just now I told you the number of effective atoms per each cube, the number of effective atoms per each cube. For PCC it is 1, for BCC it is 2, and for FCC it is 4. NaCl is having the arrangement of FCC, and number of particles present in FCC arrangement is 4. That is why I have taken 4. So in one unit cell, 4 atoms will be there. So these 4 atoms will represent one. So mass of one unit cell. Mass of one unit cell will be equal to, density is equal to mass by volume. Isn't it? Density is equal to mass by volume. Mass of unit cell will be equal to density into volume. Okay. And the formula for density is, density of unit cell is given by atomic mass into number of effective atoms into volume into Avogadro number. This is the formula I gave you for density. Mass by volume. Mass of unit cell is m into number of effective atoms by volume into Avogadro number, right? Into volume is A cube. Volume is A cube. A cube will be cancelled, right? And then substitute atomic mass where NaCl. Here it is, we have a molecular formula. Sodium is 23, atomic mass of sodium is 23, plus chlorine atomic mass is 35.5, which is 58.5. So the molecular mass of NaCl will be 58.5. So it will be 58.5 into Z. What is the Z value for FCC? Z is nothing but number of effective atoms, which is 4. So into 4 by Avogadro number, which is 6.023 into 10 power 23. 6.023 into 10 power 23. What is this value? This value is mass of one unit cell. This value is mass of one unit cell. Now we will see number of unit cells. So number of unit cells in 1 gram. Number of unit cells in 1 gram. Will be equal to 1 by mass of one unit cell. 1 by mass of one unit cell. Right? So it will be 1 by mass of one unit cell that we got is 58.5 into 4 by 6.023 into 10 power 23. So this ratio will be inverted. So it will be equal to 6.023 into 10 power 23 upon 58.5 into 4. And on simplifying this, we will get the number of unit cells is 2.5 into 10 power 21. Okay. So this is about number of unit cells according to the given data. Okay. Someone has unmuted, please check it out. So in this way we can calculate number of unit cells with the formula of density. Once again, I'm explaining, listen carefully. Since they have given that NaCl, and NaCl is FCC, that is why we know that number of particles is 4. That is nothing but Z value. And mass of one unit cell. Mass of one unit cell will be, if density is equal to mass into volume, mass will be equal to density into volume. Density formula is a molecular mass into Z by A cube into N naught into volume. Volume is A cube. A cube, A cube get cancelled. So it is molecular mass into effective atoms by Avogadro number. NaCl. NaCl is made up of sodium and chlorine. Sodium atomic mass is 23. Chlorine is 35.5. So it is 58.5. Into number of effective atoms is 4. Right. So this is mass of one unit cell. Okay. Mass of one unit cell. Then number of unit cells in 1 gram. Number of unit cells in 1 gram will be 1 by mass of one unit cell. That on calculating, we'll get this number of unit cells. Okay. Copy. Next one is next one also we'll see based on the same formula only. The same formula of density we are going to check. This time he wanted you to calculate the molar mass of the solid. As I told you, analysis is the important aspect of a chemist. If an unknown substance is given to you, you would be able to identify what is the nature of atom, what is the different type of atoms present in it, and what is the different types of bonds in it, what is the repeated units in it, and what kind of molecule it is made up of. So this is the important aspects of chemist when he is supposed to analyze an unknown substance given to you, right? So we are going to do a numerical based on knowing this atomic mass or molar mass. A solid, question is, a solid having density, nine into 10 cube kg per meter cube. Remember, units are also very, very important in certain numericals. Okay, forms face centered cubic lattice, that is FCC crystal, FCC crystal of edge length, FCC of edge length 200 and root 2 picometer. See this, he measured the density in terms of meters, but he gave the edge length in terms of picometer. So we should convert this picometer into meters. Both the units that you are going to substitute in one formula should be identical. Either density should be in picometer or this edge length is supposed to be in meter, right? Picometer. What is the molar mass of the solid? What is the molar mass of solid? This is the question. This can be easily answered compared to the last one, where the formula for density is density of a solid is equal to molecular mass of that solid into number of effective atoms, that is Z, by volume of the cube, that is A cube, and into volume of the cube, which is A cube, into Avogadro number. This is the formula. Right? The thing is, he wanted you to calculate molar mass. So write the formula for molar mass from this. So molar mass will be equal to density into A cube into Avogadro number by number of effective atoms. Right? And here density is given. What is the density? 9 into 10 cube kg meter inverse 3. Since it is in meters, the adjunct, that A is the adjunct, it is also supposed to be in meters only. And 1 picometer is equal to 10 power minus 12 meters. 1 picometer is equal to 10 power minus 12 meters or 10 power minus 10 centimeters. Since we require in meters only, we substitute the same 200 root 2 into 10 power minus 12 meter. Right? And we need A cube. Don't forget that. We need A cube. Okay? Now substitute these values here. Density is 9 into 10 cube into 200 root 2 into 10 power minus 12 whole cube into 6.023 into 10 power 23 upon Z. What is the value of Z here? Any one of you? What is the value of Z here?
4.
4. Why 4?
Sir, the FCC is 4, no sir.
Yeah. What is your name, my dear?
Vaishnavi, sir.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Yes, it is 4. Why? Because it is FCC. Right? You have to simplify. There is no other option. You have to simplify all this. So it will be 10 power minus 12 into 3 in the sense, it will be 36 minus 36 and 23. Minus 36 and 23 in the sense, it will be 10 power minus 6. Minus 36.
Minus 13.
Minus 13. Minus 13 and this cube. So it will be 10 power minus 10. Minus 10 and 9. 200 cube. We have this 200 cube also. We'll do one thing. We'll write this 200 as 2 into 10 square. 2 into 10 square. 10 square into 10 power minus 12 will be, it will be 10 power minus 10. So 10 power minus 10 whole cube will be 10 power minus 30. Right? 10 power minus 30, then first we'll do this 10 part so that it will be helpful. Otherwise, it will be difficult. So we are calculating the molecular mass. So it will be 9 into 10 cube. And we will be writing it as 2 into 10 square. This 200 is writing as 2 into 10 square. 10 square into 10 power minus 12 will be 10 power minus 10. So it will be 2 root 2 into 10 power minus 10 whole cube, 10 power minus 10 whole cube, and 6.023 into 10 power 23 upon 4. Okay. Right. Then minus 30, and here 9 into, it will be 2 cube means 8, square root 2 means whole power 1 by 2, so it will be 2 power 3 by 2 into 6.023 into 10 cube and 10 power minus 30, 10 cube and 10 power minus 30 will be 10 power minus 27, 10 power minus 27 and 23 will be 10 power minus 4 upon 4. So it will be 2 times and 18, 2 power 3 by 2, 1.5. So it will be 18 and 102, which is by 2, so it will be coming around 0.03, and on simplifying, this coming as 0.0305. kg per meter cube. Not meter cube, kg, just kg. In terms of kg only, he wanted you to calculate. That's why we got this. Okay, so this is about how we calculate atomic mass in scientific analysis. Okay, so this is all about solid state and different aspects of it. I think I have covered most of the corners of this topic, right? Is there any suggestions that you would like to give, any one of you, if you want to interact even?
So can you send some important questions like maximum of 20 to 25 so that we can solve of the topics what you have taught daily?
Okay.
Right. And discuss in the next class.
Discuss in the next class. I think we have one particular topic to be completed. Actually, this 1.5 hour time is not time. Okay, if whatever the you do one thing, I will be posting in the group, WhatsApp group, and not all of the questions that I forwarded, you just mark the common questions that everyone felt difficult. That questions I am going to discuss in the next class. Otherwise, we will not be having a complete time for a discussion of all the topics and the completion of the next topic also. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Anyone else? Is there any difficulties or problems that you felt in today's class? Okay, then hope you all enjoyed the class. See you soon tomorrow at 2 o'clock. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.